Good evening, children.
Good evening.
How are you today?
Fine.
Okay. Let me introduce myself. I am Supriya. I came from Jannaram. I am studying DLL second year in Gowdet, Karimnagar. Shall we start our class?
Yes.
First of all, I take two numbers. They are 343 and 7. Here, in these two numbers, which is the biggest number? Okay. Which is the smallest number?
7.
Do you know division method?
Yes.
Okay. Here, 343 is bigger than 7. Then, 343 is divisible by 7. 7 is not divisible by 343. Because 343 is bigger than 7. Now I am using division method. Here 343 is bigger than 7. That's why I am taking 343 as a dividend. 7 as divisor. Here, what is the first digit?
3.
3 is less than 7. 3 is not divisible by 7. Now I take two numbers. It is 34. 34 is bigger than 7. How many 7s are in 34?
4.
28. Now I do subtraction. What is the remainder here?
6.
Now I carry 3. Here, how many 7s are in 63?
9.
Remainder is 0. Here remainder is 0. Then 343 is divisible by 7. This is one process of solving this type of problems. Do you know another process? No. Without actual division, we can say, is this number divisible or not, with the help of divisibility rule. Do you know divisibility rule? Divisibility rule means the process of checking whether a number is divisible by a given number or not without actual division is called divisibility rule. Already you know the divisibility rules of 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10, 11. Do you know the divisibility rule of 7? Now let us have a discussion on divisibility rule of 7. What is this? Tell me.
Divisibility rule of
7. In this rule, we have four steps. They are, first step is multiply last digit by 2. Second one is subtract from remaining number. What is the second step?
Subtract
from remaining number. Third one is repetition. Fourth one is check division by 7. Here in this rule we have four steps. What are they? Please say loud. And repetition. Fourth one is check division by 7. This rule is applicable for 3-digit number or more than 3-digit numbers. Tell me some 3-digit numbers? Shashi. Okay, 420. Sahaja, tell me 4-digit number. 5495. Okay. And let us check it. First I take the number 420. We have 4 steps. According to that steps, what is the first step? Multiply last digit by 2. In this number, what is last digit? 0. Okay. 0 into 2, what?
Zero.
What is the product of these two numbers?
0.
0. Okay. What is our next step?
Subtract
from remaining number. Here, remaining number is?
42.
42 minus?
0.
0. What is the result?
42.
Okay. What is our next step?
Repetition.
Repeating this process till we get 2-digit number. Already here we get 2-digit number. Then go to next step. What is our next step? Check division by 7.
42 by 7. Here 42 is divisible by 7 or not?
Yes.
How many 7s are in 42?
6.
Now here remainder is
0. Then here 2-digit number is divisible by 7. Then the given number is also divisible by 7. Now check another number.
5495.
Here what is last digit?
5.
First step, according to first step,
5 into 2, 10. Second step,
subtract from remaining number.
Here remaining number is?
549.
549 minus
10?
539.
Okay. Third step is? Repetition. Here we get 3-digit number. Okay. That's why we do repetition. Here, what is last digit?
9.
9. 9 into 2?
18.
Now, we subtract this result from remaining number. 53.
53 minus 18?
35.
Okay. What is our fourth step? Check division by?
Here 35 by 7. 35 is divisible by 7 or not?
Yes.
7 5s are? 35. Here remainder is?
0.
This 2-digit number is divisible by 7. Then the given number is also divisible by 7. Is it clear to all?
Yes.
Okay. If we have 3 or 4-digit number, we can solve in this way easily. It takes less time. But if we have 10-digit number or more than 10-digit number, we can solve in this way also. But it takes more time. We want to solve that type of problems in less time. How can we solve this type of problems? Now we have another method. Okay. Now I take 10-digit number, that is 87906022900. This is 10-digit number. In this method, first we divide this number into 3 digits in like this. Okay, is it clear? Okay, let us consider A, B, C, D. First, we divide the given number in this way. Let us consider A, B, C, D. Then next, the numbers which are in even places, Now we add the numbers which are in even places. B, D.
B plus D. Here, B means 602 plus D means 8.
What is the result here?
610.
Now we added the numbers which are in odd places.
A plus C. A means 900.
C means 790.
What is the result here?
The addition of two numbers is
1690.
Here, in these two numbers, which is the biggest number? 1690. Then, 610 is subtract from 1690. 1690 minus 610. A plus C minus B plus D. What is the result here?
What? 1080.
Here we get 4 digit number. Here we get 4 digit number. Then we apply above process. Then we get answer. Okay? Is it clear to all?
Yes.
Okay. Up to now, what we learned today?
Divisibility rule of 7.
Okay, thank you.